Hey Danielle, how are you?
I'm okay. How are you today?
I'm
welcome.
Good. So why don't you identify yourself first?
Okay, well, I'm Danielle Turner. I'm the Vice President of One-Stop Operations for Career Resources. I oversee the American Job Center programs for Stanford, Bridgeport, and the Valley, which is the Sonia and Derby office, so Southwest all.
Okay, and where are we standing right now?
Right now, we are standing in the Bridgeport American Job Center, adjacent to, of course, the Department of Labor. And this is our center resource for the community.
Okay, and what's the status of the job center right now?
Well, right now, for one-on-one appointments, naturally the center is closed due to the pandemic, but we are working on a virtual platform.
Okay, and we are social distancing, we're 6 feet
mm-hmm.
apart, and when we're not on camera, we're wearing masks.
Mm-hmm.
So how accessible is the center to, say, the disabled, the elderly, people with needs? Is it ADA compliant?
Well, yes. Prior to COVID, the American Job Center is in a partnership, but we still are in a partnership with BRS, and we work with a number of partners in the community for on the Bureau of Rehabilitation Services, and they are still working with us, but more or less on a virtual platform. So these days, our partners would reach out to us either by email. We're set up Zoom sessions to have conversations about ferrying their customers into the AJC services. So we're in compliance and we're still providing those services.
So in some ways, it's actually even more accessible for people because they don't actually have to physically be here.
Yeah, and actually that's something that we've learned in the middle of working virtually, that for customers that cannot access the center on foot, they can definitely now get us quicker.
Okay, so we're in the Career Center now. So what technology is available to help clients or businesses that have challenges?
Okay, so here in the Career Center, naturally there are computers, and we have a resource center coordinator that would assist customers that are faced with any challenges with just overall trying to, you know, just become friendly with utilizing a computer. A lot of our customers haven't done it before,
okay.
So Ms. Regina is also here assisting with that. And then individuals that are visually challenged or they have any disabilities, there is equipment that we use along with our partner, which is BRS. They come in twice a week with us, and the customers can access the assisted technology, Zoom features,
okay.
That would help them and otherwise be able to complete their resume or follow any type of program procedures that they're looking to interact with.
Okay, so typically, if we didn't have a pandemic and someone didn't have access to a laptop
mm-hmm.
or a mobile phone, they could still come in here and find some of that.
Yes, 5 days a week.
Technology here. Okay. So when someone enters the job center, how do they know where to go and or what to do?
Okay, that's a good question. What we actually do, we would triage customers either at the initial desk. They come in, they explain to us either they want to enroll in a training program that's being offered. We would get them recruited into, of course, CT Hires, and the registration is done so that they will become a part of now our network and the workforce development. So then Ms. Regina would be present here for individuals that are seeking to use the computers themselves.
Okay, and so now during the pandemic, if someone needs the services here, they just call or
well, they'll
online?
Call. What we've actually done, depending on what program it's been, right now the Jobs First Employment Services is providing pads for customers that are in need. So even though we don't greatly advertise it, because naturally we couldn't provide the entire community with pads to use, we have done it for a selective group of individuals. And then of course, Scott has also assisted with providing us with loaner pads for customers that are in training.
Okay.
So if we have to, we try to definitely find a way to get that done.
Right, so if someone was looking to find out about the services here, probably the best place to start is either the phone or online on our website?
Yeah, you would visit the American Job Center website as well as Career Resources, and then, of course, Department of Labor. All the information, because they're all partner programs, will be available to the general public.
Okay, and you don't have to be unemployed or necessarily someone, a dislocated worker, to utilize the services.
No, it's a community center. Most people come in to make prints. They're going on job interviews. So even if they don't want to utilize any internal services, the center is still here for them.
So who are the people that are served by this job center?
Okay, so in this job center, this is the Bridgeport location. So naturally, individuals that live in the Bridgeport community. And then this building itself is considered the one-stop center because it's the central location for our funded workplace, career resources, as well as Department of Labor. But since then, of course, now the workplace and career resources has moved over to 1000 Lafayette, and then the American Job Center is still present in this building.
Okay, so I can come here if I'm unemployed, but also if I'm looking for new skills, or if I'm looking for help with my resume or things like that as well, right?
Yes, of course. The individuals that are on staff are skilled in a lot of different areas, and I like my staff being fully skilled. I've always said in the past that we should all be able to sit at one another's station and still conduct CRI's business, whether individuals are coming in to do a skill up, if individuals are coming through the door for a resume critique, because not everyone is here for training and they don't stay, but they do utilize the services that are here in the community.
Okay. So what kinds of workshops are offered here?
Okay, so the workshops offered under the American Job Center, you have your Jobs First Employment Services for individuals that are receiving cash assistance. Department of Social Services referred them here so they can begin to work with case management to help them get back on track of finding employment, because they only have 21 months to receive a cash assistance grant in the state of Connecticut. So that's vital time to work with them to either get them back on their feet and off to employment. And then, of course, we have the Workforce Initiatives Opportunities Act, which is WIOA, affectionately called, where individuals come in seeking a skill up. They want to attend occupational skills training to either get some sort of license or credential that would help them with finding greater employment or even getting into a new industry.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the workshops, they're offered all kinds of days and times? So
yes. It's a lot of different workshops. We have digital literacy. There's ESL workshops for individuals that are learning English as a second language. Mm-hmm. There are workshops hosted on our coach, which is our virtual lab. Same thing. Everything's skilled around individuals trying to find employment.
Okay. And again, you're not doing those in person these days.
No, they're all on a more virtual platform. And what we've done as a staff is to try to learn to work virtually and still do, you know, vital outreach to our customers on a daily basis. But because of, you know, the status of things right now, we have to work this way. But they're still all available in the community, and they're on a calendar.
So who are the community partners that you work with, whether it's state, local, public or private organizations that you work with to provide these programs at the center?
Well, okay. Well, Career Resources, of course, Department of Labor, the workplace, adult education, VRS, our community colleges partners are major ones, and a lot of our smaller private partners.
Okay. And so how do people find out about the programs and services that are available? Are we talking your brochures? You mentioned an online calendar. So if I want to participate in a workshop or a program, where do I go? How do I find out about it?
Well, right now, because of the height of COVID, we've moved on now virtually. So a lot of that information is found on the websites, the American Job Site, the American Job Center website, mm-hmm. Career Resources, Department of Labor. It's there. And then we've also embedded guided videos for an individual that's looking to come in to start a training. We've now walked you through the process of CT Hire's registration and the pre-application in order to maintain contact with the case managers. Shortly after that, the case managers start contacting customers, and we've done a number of marketing strategies to get the information out to the community, working along with our partner programs to ensure that we're letting everyone in the community know that we're still here, we're still working with customers, and to refer as many as they can.
Okay, and the case managers will tell people what they're eligible for and what they need to do to be able to register for those programs.
Yes, because, well, if you're thinking more or less on a WIOA platform, the eligibility for that program is based on naturally family size, income, citizenship. We have to address those up front. Mm-hmm. But we do have an eligibility team that will work along with customers to determine whether they're eligible. And then if they're not, there's other training programs that we can definitely have them participate in that doesn't meet the WIOA requirements.
Great. For people who want to participate in the workshops or the programs, is there any documentation that's required that they have to provide to the AJC?
Yeah, once again, it truly depends on what program that they're looking for. Every program has an eligibility requirement, but there are some that don't require any documentation. But yes, there are some documents that are needed for application processes and eligibility.
Okay, and are there any fees for any of it?
Well, no. Individuals that come that get serviced by the American Job Center, if an individual is going to a training, if they make us aware that they need assistance, mm-hmm. we try our best to gather assistance for them in the form of support dollars if they're available. For individuals that barriers will become for testing, if they're trying to pay for their tests and they can't afford it. then we would definitely step in and try to assist if there are support dollars available that year.
Right, so that could be like scholarships or grants that are available.
Yes, scholarships, grants, and it's all a part of working with our fund at the workplace. They would assist us with that.
Okay. So what kind of support services actually are available? You know, whether it's, I know there's like income tax preparation assistance and things like that. What kind of programs and services are available?
Well, currently we're in, of course, our tax quota with VITA. So our VITA tax program has kicked off for the year where individuals are completing their taxes here free of charge. So we always encourage the community to take advantage of that because, as you know, it's expensive to get your taxes done. There's community resources that's available 5 days a week here. And now, of course, we're doing it virtually, but individuals can come in for assistance with food, diaper. And we even have an outside community resource service market that's actually helping individuals every Saturdays for groceries at Wade's Dairy. Individuals that are going into training, if they're seeking training dollars and they cannot afford to take their tests, some of these tests are over hundreds of dollars, we may assist with support services to help someone pay for their tests.
Okay. And there's also financial literacy training and
yes,
things like that.
That's actually a new one. The Financial Opportunity Center was kicked off this year. And the advisor there, Chuck, he's working with individuals to provide coaching to help individuals actually manage their finances in the middle of this pandemic.
Yeah, that's awesome. And again, there's, you mentioned food assistance, there's clothing assistance too, I guess.
Yes. Right? We have a program called Stephanie's Closets for Men that it's recently located here in the building. We're still setting up. As customers start to return to us, we're hoping when of course the pandemic is over and they return to the center, but of course can be accessed virtually to obtain those services. There's also the Dress of Success program that works along with us through, of course, the workplace that women can go get suits for going out into job interviews. Now you're doing a lot of that stuff virtually now, right. But it's still nice to look good.
Yeah, terrific. So how do you let people know what's going on here? What's your marketing and outreach plan?
Well, right now, naturally, we moved in with the times. Everything's virtual. So Career Resources has a Facebook page, is American Job Center Facebook page. We have Instagram. We have Twitters. And, of course, we have a newsletter that goes out weekly to about 5,000 people.
Excellent. And you've got the Career Resources website as well?
Yes. The Career Resources website. Individuals can reach out to us on a lot of different platforms, and then of course our partner programs are also, they're marketing the program for us. They're letting consumers know that we're back and that we're here. You know, we're presently here. So we did a huge marketing push to all the partner programs in the community as well as our vendors.
And you get referrals from other organizations, especially like State Department, State Department of Labor and others, right?
Yes, on a daily basis. They come in quite frequently. And then, of course, Department of Labor is one of the larger marketing tools that we've been utilizing because, of course, we work as a partnership. So a lot of their customers have also come through the American Job Center. And we are currently even doing calls that are Zoom sessions for their RESA customers as well as their TAA.